All right.
So I haven't seen Soul. I haven't seen Onward. But right out the gate, I can tell you exactly what's on D-list. Cars, trash. All of them. Straight garbage. Don't need them. Why were they even made? You know what I'm saying? Cars is doo-doo. And if I'm being completely honest, it might not even be the movie that gave me the fucking negative vibes. It's that goddamn song from Rascal Flatts that just is annoying as fuck. And it automatically put a bad taste in my mouth for the whole series. If you like that song, yeah, that song is garbage. Life is a highway, I'm gonna ride it. All right, so we got that out the way. Do you want me to go like in order that I think that they should be? Or do you want me to go and put them like in order? Up. S tier, quite obviously. You know what I'm saying? Let me tell you something about Up. I can only watch maybe one every 4 years, and I have to skip through the movie because I don't want to see any of the sad scenes. I cried in the scene when they do like the montage of their life. Then I cried when what's his name said that he didn't have no family and the old man was his only family. Then I cried when we found out Kevin wasn't a girl, or that Kevin's a girl. And then I cried again when I was like, damn, she's just trying to get back to her babies. And then when the dog was like, yo, I'm just trying to be a good boy. And then on top of that, I cried whenever Kevin left to go be with the babies. I'm like, Kevin's fucking our boy. Pause, phrasing, terrible, terrible wordage right there, but you know what I meant. I've cried too many times to this shit. So moral of the story, Up is sad as fuck, but hilarious at the same time. Toy Story? No, this is when we're gonna get down into the nitty gritty right here. Toy Story, S tier. Obviously. And let me tell you why it's S tier. Because it was the first animated movie fucking ever. And it still holds up today. I remember going to Toy Story World in Disneyland. No, Disney World. The one in Florida. They had a Mr. Potato Head that was like life size, like probably 7 feet tall on a pedestal. He had AI in him. So the AI like was looking at you. So his eyes would move and then he would fucking talk to you. Hey, you in the striped shirt. Toy Story. Obviously top of the class. Now we get into some garbo with Monsters University. This, it's one of these two. I think I'm going D to be honest. Nah, we're going C. It's a good movie. It was just kind of like, for what, you know? Finding Dory, also C. Finding Dory was them just trying to capitalize on the fact that all of us that watched it when we were 10, that we were gonna have the nostalgia and we were automatically gonna go watch it 15 years later. The jokes didn't hit, like they didn't hit the same way. Dory to me is like Patrick Starr. He's not gonna be able to handle his own. You know what I'm saying? He needs a cast of characters around him. Finding Nemo, S class, it's not even a question. This is where we discovered Dory. The sharks, the fucking nice sharks. I was like, oh damn, I forgot clownfish live in this shit. All right, next up, Incredibles, S tier. Incredibles 1 at least. Obviously, the Incredibles is S tier just because the mom was packing, you know what I'm saying? The animators knew what was up. Man, Incredibles was crazy. It was a whole action movie. Normally these movies aren't action movies. They're like little kid action movies. Where's my super suit? Next up, Ratatouille is the GOAT Pixar movie. Don't even fucking at me. Ratatouille is by far the best movie Pixar has ever made. It's not even a question. I don't even know how, like, it's sad, but there's a lot of determination there. Probably also talking about like some type of socio-political class like war in the fact that like the rat is obviously poor, so he can't go and be the master chef that he could be because we see them as less than, but he still ends up becoming that because he's overcoming all adversity. This motherfucker's out here with all. All right, next, Good Dinosaur. That's A tier. It's only A tier because of how sad it is. This one rips your shit, you know what I'm saying? Everybody that's seen this movie cried. If you didn't cry, I don't know what to tell you. Yes, Bug's Life is B. It's solid, but it wasn't as good as the movies that came out in the era. When was Bug's Life? Finding Nemo time? It's like, it just can't compete with the big dogs, you know what I'm saying? It's close to being B. Incredibles 2. It's not S for sure. I think I'm gonna go high B. It's like a B plus. It was good. It's one of those like, it could have been better. For all the time that they had between the original and the sequel, could have been better. Now we're getting into the thick of things now. WALL-E, S class. WALL-E is definitely S class, no question about it. This motherfucker predicted like the future that we're all headed to. It's like we saw the movie. Pixar was like, this is the future we're destined for if we keep up our ways. And we saw it and we were like, that life doesn't seem too bad. So let's just keep on trucking along. You know what I'm saying? All these other movies so far, you could say they were for little kids and they had like adult themes. But WALL-E and Ratatouille were the two movies that were most definitely kids liked them because they were animated. But the story behind the actual plot was definitely for the adults that's taking them to watch the kid movies. So now we're at Monsters, Inc. Monsters, Inc. D, just kidding. AS, obviously. S is where it's at. When I saw Monsters, Inc. and when I saw the door concept, when they were fucking like in that last scene where they're jumping door to door, my mind was fucked, like blown. I was like, holy shit. This might have been the dopest concept that I've ever seen in my life. Like literally jumping from door to door and during a chase. And then I also thought during that scene, I was like, is this what it looks like in the baggage section of the airport? Like behind the little flaps? Is it just luggage all over the fucking place? How does my luggage never get lost? The ending got you, Zorro? Same, yo. But when Mike Wazowski's like, these are the jokes, kid. Shit makes me laugh every time. Inside Out. This is low-key one of the better movies. It's I don't know if it's S tier, but the whole concept of like the different balls, I'm not sure. Just the whole concept of every single little person having like these balls. Not people having balls. You know what I'm saying. You've seen the movie. Like they get sucked down. That's worse. That doesn't help my story either. I got 5 or 6 characters in me too. I feel like all of these movies that have like adult themes through them, like Up, WALL-E, Ratatouille, and Inside Out, I feel like these are all S tier just because of how that they're like made for the adults, you know? So now we move on to Coco. This is tough because I don't want my Hispanic heritage. I don't want it to cloud my judgment on this movie. I think we're gonna put it at, it should be B, but the fact that this is like the first movie where a major production studio like actually researched and made a movie around the Hispanic heritage, I feel like that's a big win. That's a big win for Pixar. It's automatically gonna get an A because the fucking villain is named Ernesto, and I don't appreciate that. As a white guy, it's really well done. How dare you have input on something other than white culture? Next, we got Toy Story 2.
Coco is S and I am white AF. Great movie about ancestry. Beautiful animation, lights, and music.
God damn it, Paralyze. You bribed me into it, bro. I could never be in public work because I'm just gonna get fucking bribes all day and I'm gonna take them. You're gonna see me showing up at court at an arraignment wearing a fur coat that somebody bought me so that way I could donate money in that direction. Taxpayer money. Everybody's gonna be wondering where the COVID shots are and I'm driving past the line all vaxxed up in my fucking Maybach. So, Toy Story 3? S tier, no doubt about it. Toy Story 3 is like the fucking perfect storm of Toy Story movies, and it's the saddest one. That one where they're fucking when they're going down the incinerator chute. Oh my God, my child! Why would they do that to us? Why would they not put a warning at the beginning of the movie about that? Normally trilogies they like lose steam as they go. Looking at you, Matrix. So the fact that Toy Story 3 was the best, we only went in this direction. Brave, S class. Not even a question about Brave. You know why? Because she's like the first Disney princess where I fucking respected. Brave is mid? Anything fucking Frozen is mid. Ernest had a crush on the redhead. All right, so first off, I was already way too old to be crushing on a 12-year-old. But also, she was like a badass chick. You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't like a traditional, princess story. She was brave for wanting to step out there and not be the traditional type of princess that Disney has. Brave and Frozen, I think, were the only two Pixar movies that I can think of where there was like no man needed to save the day. Like they did it all. Frozen, there's not a dude in sight. There's a dude in sight, but he's useless. Are we talking about the snowman? The ice picking dude? Oh yeah, Doctor. You see, he's so little in the movie that I didn't even remember his character. This is probably the only movie that I haven't seen on the list. Boom. That's how low Cars is, in my opinion. To be honest, if we put a Tom Mack, it's probably gonna be above Cars. Just saying. Okay, so Toy Story 4, I'm probably gonna put it at C, only because of the fucking legacy that it had to follow up with. It was destined for it to fail. Y'all thinking B? Yeah, you know what? Cars/... Boom. All right, you're right. I'll give it a B. I'll give it a B minus. All right, Soul. Last one. Soul is either S or A. I think we're gonna put it at S. It would be A for me, but it's also the same reason why Coco was an S tier. Because now we got a black dude as a lead character who had never, that had never been done before. Also parallel, so on top of it, it was also an amazing movie. And I was mad skeptical too, because it was a movie that was released to Disney Plus only. So in my mind, it had like the straight to DVD type stigma around it. You know what I'm saying? So the fact that it was a dope ass movie, then on top of the fact that it's about jazz music, which kids don't give a fuck about jazz. So the fact that they even ventured there. And then on top of that, they like paid homage and respect to the African-Americans that brought up jazz, and then our main character is black, automatically S. So obviously we don't rarely get bad Pixar movies, and then on top of that, the ones that we do get are bad, they're shitty sequels, this doesn't count, I haven't watched, or they're real bad and you call them Cars 1, 2, and 3.